Hello everyone, today we're taking a look at this mini PC to see what it's capable of and how it performs in everyday tasks and games. Hit the like button and let's start. Here's a Beelink SER4 that I got from Amazon for $350. In the box we have PC itself, two HDMI cables, mount bracket with screws, a 57 watts power adapter and manual. The case is made of plastic with a metal bottom and cooling meshes. Even though it's a mini PC, it has a rich and thoughtful port configuration. On the front we have a power button with commonly used ports, which are two USB 3.0 ports, one Type-C port and 3.5mm jack. And on the back side we have a power port, two HDMI ports, two USB ports and an Ethernet port. So let's set it up. You may use a bracket to mount it on the back of your monitor and use a short HDMI cable, or you can go with a more traditional way and place it on the desk. It has a rubber mats on the bottom for stability and damping of micro vibrations. I am using a 144Hz 1080p monitor and wireless mouse keyboard combo. The setup was quick and looks clean with this mini PC. A lot of space saving and ports are easily accessible. Let's turn it on and we have a Windows 11 Pro welcome screen. Setup was quick, Windows 11 was ready to go in 3 minutes and the PC automatically picked up the correct settings for the monitor. The system feels responsive and quick. I tried to open a bunch of tabs in the browser while running a 4K video and I had no delays or lags. Wi-Fi and Bluetooth work stable. After using this PC I can say overall performance is great. This PC can easily become your everyday PC. It works fast in office software and it won't disappoint you even in demanding software like Photoshop. Another cool feature is that we have a multiple monitor support from the box. On the back we have two HDMI and Type-C on the front also can work as a display port. So I was able to build two or even three monitor setup and it works perfectly. 1080p 144Hz on all monitors. The system still performs smoothly and I think this PC is great solution even for free monitor setup. Let's now talk about hardware inside. This PC runs on Ryzen 7 4700U, which is a laptop CPU with 8 cores and 8 threads, up to 4.1 GHz. The CPU has 7 core Radeon graphics with 1600 MHz frequency. In pair with this CPU, we have 16GB of DDR4 RAM on 3200 MHz frequency. And for storage, we have 500GB Kingston M2 SSD. 500GB is an optimal amount, but you can switch to more capacity SSD or you can also upgrade storage by adding 2.5mm SSD or HDD, simply slide it into a spot and screw. RAM also can be upgraded, you can install up to 64GB, but I don't think it's reasonable for this PC. 16GB in dual channel performing great. I should give another credit for cooling. Cooler noise simply does not exist when using this PC. And in stress test, it keeps the temperature under 85 degrees. Now let's move to the games. Let's start from light and move to more demanding games. In Minecraft on medium-high graphics, we have 120 plus FPS most of the time, and I was even able to run it on 3 monitors. In that case, on low graphics, seeing 80 plus FPS all time with good frame time graph. In Valorant on low settings 1080p, getting 100 plus FPS with straight frame time graph. CPU temperature stays around 80 degrees here. Rocket League on high settings full HD seeing around 40 FPS. The frame time is not perfect, but the game runs pretty smooth. On 3 monitors getting 35 FPS with graphic settings in performance mode. Even though we have a console FPS, the game feels great. In Midnight Fighter, getting 40 to 50 FPS with straight frame time graph on high settings full HD. And on 3 monitors getting 25 to 30 FPS with low graphics settings. In Stray on low 1080p graphics, we have 30 FPS with drops to 20 FPS at some locations. Temperature stays around 75 degrees. On a triple monitor, I had to lower the resolution scale to 50% on low settings, and in that case, the frame rate jumps between 10 to 30 FPS. Elden Ring on low settings 1080p, seeing under 30 FPS with micro freezes sometimes. Spider-Man Remastered, and here big shout out to AMD for FSR 2.0. On low settings 1080p with FSR 2.0 in high performance mode, mode, getting console 35fps without freezes. As an experiment, I tried running it on 3 monitors, and in that case, with the same settings, the frame rate is under 20fps. This mini PC shows amazing performance for the price. It can easily handle any office or hobby task, and also shows good performance for mini PC in games. It has thoughtful design, takes minimum space on the desk, and can easily be transported. And if you are an Apple fan, you can check my Mac Mini M1 review, which is now the cheapest Apple PC you can get. Don't forget to share your thoughts in the comments and subscribe to see more tech content like this.